Hello everyone, today we will see nested loop join in query processing. So learning outcome for this session is students will be able to analyze the cost of join operation using nested loop join algorithm. Now whenever we want to perform a join of two relations, which algorithm will be used and what will be its cost, that we have to see. So today we will see nested loop join. So what do you mean by nested loop join is that we are having two relations R and S. So one will be the outer relation and one will be the inner relation. So here we are considering that R is an outer relation and S is an inner relation, because for every tuple of R, we are comparing every tuple of S. Or when we are comparing the tuples of R and S, so first tuple, one tuple from relation R will be taken to the main memory, and then all the relations or all the tuples of the relation S will be brought to main memory and compared. And that's why the algorithm is for each tuple TR in R and for each tuple TS, means that first tuple from R will be taken and then it will be compared with every tuple of S. So test the pair to say whether they are satisfying the condition or not, and if they are satisfying the condition, that concatenation of these two tuples will be added to the result. So this is what nested loop join is. Now we will see this in detail with the example. So consider we have to perform employee and department join. So here employee considered as an outer relation and department you consider it as an inner relation. So how it will work? So take the first tuple of employee and check the values of common attributes with all the tuples of this department relation. So first record will be taken and then it will be compared with the first tuple. So this department ID 01 is matching with department ID 01. That's why these tuples will be concatenated and will be added to the result. Then this first record will be compared with second. Then the first record will compare with third one. Then the same record with the fourth one. And then the first record with the fifth one. So all the five records will be compared with the first tuple. So once this will be finished, the complete relation, then the second tuple will be brought to main memory, and then again this tuple will be compared with all the records of this department. So in this way, every tuple will be compared with a complete relation, that is department, and this is how nested loop join works. So this nested loop join does not require any index, because we are going sequentially from the first tuple to the last tuple. This is very expensive, because as we have seen, it will examine every tuple in this two relation. So consider NR are the tuples in relation R and NS are the tuples in relation S. Then total number of comparisons will be, of course, NR into NS. Or in the previous example, we can see that here there are 9 records and here there are 5 records. So total comparisons will be 9 into 5, that is 45. Okay, so here complete scan of S will be done for every record of R. Now we will check the performance of this nested loop join. So assume that a buffer can hold only one block of relation. So how many block transfers will be required? So we will be requiring BR are the blocks of the relation R and BS are the blocks of relation S. Then all the blocks of relation R will be brought to memory only once. That's why BR block transfers are required for relation R. But how many block transfers will be required for S? So for every tuple of relation R, the complete relation S is going to be scanned. So all the blocks of relation S will be brought to main memory, and that's why NR into BS block transfers will be required for relation S. So total number of block transfers will be NR into BS plus BR. This is worst case possibility. Then how many 6 will be required? So only 1 6 for every relation S, because S will be read sequentially. So we are taking the first block, then second block and third block. So for one read, it will be 1 6, and we are reading relation S NR times, as many tuples in R. That's why we will be requiring NR 6 operations for relation S. Whereas for this BR, we are bringing the blocks one by one, and that's why we will be requiring BR seek operations for relation R. So total number of seek operations will be NR plus BR for nested loop join in worst case. So what can be the best case? So if there is enough space to hold the relations into the main memory, then we will be requiring the reading of blocks only once, and that's why the total number of blocks will block transfers will be BR plus BS along with 2 6, because it will be read sequentially again. So first pointer will be placed at the first block or the first tuple of the first block, and then it will be read sequentially. That's why we will be taking we'll be requiring BR plus BS block transfers. So one can be the possibility that one of the relation is fitting in main memory. So if it is that case, then it is better to have the inner relation kept it in main memory, because it will be read only once, and then we can do the comparison of this relation R and S. So in this case also, the block transfers required will be BR plus BS along with 2 6. Now let us look at the example here. So consider there are two relations, one is student and other one is text. The number of blocks in students are 5000, sorry, number of records are 5000 and number of blocks are 100, whereas in text relation the number of records are 10000 and the blocks are 400. So consider student as an outer relation and the text as an inner relation. Okay, so number of total comparisons will be of course 5000 into 10000. So let us look at this. So this is a relation student and this is a relation text. So what we will be doing is that first block will be brought to memory, and then first block of S will be also brought to main memory, and then from the first block the first tuple will be taken and which will be compared with all the records of this particular block. So let us look at this here. So first tuple will be compared with all the tuples from the first block, then the once this block will be finished, next block will be brought to memory, then the third block and fourth block. It means that for the first tuple, all the tuples from the relation S will be compared. And once this is done, the second record or the second tuple will be brought to memory. Again, this will be compared with all the tuples from all the blocks. That's why, so for one record, we are taking all the blocks, means 400 blocks of relation S. And then there are total 5000 records, and that's why the block transfers will be 5000 into 400 for relation S and 100 blocks for relation R. So total number of block transfers will be around 20,100. And the number of 6, that will be, so this will be read relation 5000 times, one per tuple of relation R, and that's why the number of 6 operations will be 5000 for relation S and 100 for relation R. So total number of 6 will be 5100. So in best case, what we have seen is that all the blocks will be read only once, and that's why if both the relations can fit in main memory, then the total number of block transfers will be 500, whereas 6 operations will be only 2. Now if we'll reverse it, that text will be the outer relation and students will be the inner relation, then pause the video and try to find out the number of block transfers and SIG operations. So for outer relation, for the tuple of outer relation, the inner relation will be read completely. Okay, so I hope you have got the same answer what we has been written. So here the first block or first tuple will be taken from relation text, and that will be compared with all the blocks of relation student. So there are total 100 blocks in the relation student. That's why for one tuple there will be 100 block transfers. For the second tuple there will be 100 block transfers. In the same manner, 10,000 tuple there will be 100 block transfers, and therefore total number of block transfers will be 10,000 into 100 for relation S plus 400 for relation R. That is nothing but text relation, and the number of block transfers, if we can see, it has been reduced to 10,400 over there, and but the number of 6 are increased because the outer relation is larger than the inner relation, and that's why 6 has become now 10,400 as compared to 5,100. And as we know that the SIG operation is more expensive than block transfer, so accordingly we have to see that which relation should be used as an inner relation and which relation should be used as an outer relation. So variation in the nested loop join is block nested loop join, where the comparison will be done block wise. So every pair of the block from relation R and S will be brought to memory and will be compared, and within that block then the comparison will be tuple wise. This will save major block accesses. So in the next lecture we will see block nested loop join. Thank you.